The medical professionals under the umbrella body of the Ugandan Medical Association have protested the move by the government to reduce the money that was allocated to the health sector by the parliament. This money includes 27 billion shillings allocated for the maintenance of ambulances, salaries for ambulance drivers and salaries for ambulance nurses, among others. During a press conference they held yesterday, the association president, Dr. Herbert Loswata, said what is most disturbing is that UNICEF has just donated 116 ambulances to the health sector. Under the prevailing circumstances, it's going to be difficult to utilize these ambulances. We are worried that if this money which was removed is not returned, nothing shall be accomplished. These ambulances now have no drivers, no fuel, and jobs for ambulance nurses at the regional level shall be lost. Loswata further revealed that the other 26 billion, which was meant for the purchase of new ambulances, has also been removed, yet these ambulances are critical. Other funds that were removed include 57 billion shillings, which was allocated towards the construction of an intensive care unit in Masaka Hospital, as well as 5 billion shillings, which was allocated for the construction of a theatre in Imbali Regional Referral Hospital. They have advised the government to reallocate funds from Members of Parliament trips towards the health sector to benefit many people. In a bid to lower maternal mortality rates in Namisindo District, Dr. Sarah Kanakwa Bwayo has launched the Safe Birth Delivery Campaign at Bopoto Health Center 3 in Namisindo District. The move is aimed at seeing all pregnant mothers attend at NENTO and give birth at health facilities with necessary kits. Dr. Kanakwa also donated over 100 mama kits and other assorted items to pregnant mothers under the watch of Namisindo District Health Officer Stefan Masai and other district leaders. She said this is aimed at safeguarding the health of both mothers and newborns.
This is a calling that the government is really talking about, safe motherhood, because we know that one of the biggest problems that are registered in the community is increasing maternal mortality, where we see that there are basically preventable deaths that we can do.
Namisindo District Health Officer Stefan Masai revealed that several mothers have been giving birth in villages at the hands of traditional birth attendants, putting their lives and that of the newborns at risk. He says this campaign is aimed at encouraging mothers to opt for health facilities when due for delivery.
We have now seen at this time that there is improvement of deliveries in hospitals and health centers, unlike in the past where they are delivering in TBS homes. And we're also discouraging them because even the government has not allowed them to deliver mothers from their homes.
Providing the basics such as mama kits to expectant mothers, as well as encouraging them to attend neonatal care in health facilities, it's a giant leap in reducing maternal mortality in the district. Hurricane Beryl made landfall Monday in the southern U.S. state of Texas, where some residents were evacuated over warnings of flooding and power outages. The U.S. National Hurricane Center said Beryl, a Category 1 storm, hit the town of Matagorda with wind speeds of 80 miles per hour. As rain and wind lashed Houston, home to 2.3 million people, the NHC warned in its latest bulletin of life-threatening storm surge, damaging winds and flooding rainfall across southern Texas. Some 1.8 million households are without electricity as of early Monday, according to the power outage U.S. tracker. According to tracking service FlightAware, George Bush Intercontinental Airport was facing nearly 1,000 flight cancellations, while the National Weather Service warned of potential for tornadoes. The NHC said rainfall up to 15 inches, 38 centimeters, was expected in parts of Texas, warning that it could cause flash flooding in some areas. Several areas of the Texas coast had already been under hurricane and storm warnings over the weekend. Matagorda lies roughly midway between the port city of Corpus Christi and Galveston Island. Authorities in Nueces County, home to Corpus Christi, asked tourists to leave the city while neighboring Refugio County, yet to recover from Hurricane Harvey in 2017, fully issued a mandatory evacuation order.